Today we're going to update the firmware of a Nikon DSLR. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm using the Nikon D5100, but the procedure should be the same for any Nikon DSLR camera. The firmware is simply built-in software that controls certain features of the camera, so Nikon occasionally releases them to add new enhancements, improve existing features, or to fix defects. Updating the firmware always involves some risk, but I'll be following the precautions and guidelines listed in Nikon's instructions. It's very important to start with a fully charged lithium-ion battery, since a power outage during the upgrade process can render the camera inoperable. Alternatively, you can use an AC adapter if you have one. I'll start off by inserting a memory card in the camera, then turning it on. Please note that I will be formatting the memory card later on, so make sure there's no critical data on the card. Otherwise, you'll want to save those files or photos elsewhere before proceeding. There's one other thing to remember, and that is, if you happen to have a camera with two memory slots, you'll want to use the slot that's assigned as the primary slot. The first thing I'll do is find out what my current firmware version is in order to see if it actually needs to be upgraded. After pressing the menu button, you'll see the user interface for the D5100. Depending on your specific model, you may or may not see the same style of menu. To find the firmware, I'll move the cursor over to the left so I can navigate the icons, then I'll press the down arrow key 3 times to the setup menu. I'll then press right to enter the grid. Scroll down to a line called Firmware Version, which happens to be the last selection in this menu, then press the OK button. On this model, you'll see 3 entries, A, B, and L. There are 2 parts to the firmware for the camera itself, labeled A and B, while the lens has its own firmware labeled L. In this video, we're going to focus on the camera body, so we'll look at the A and B portions of the firmware. Other models may have just 1 letter for the camera, which simplifies things a bit. For the D5100, label A deals with the operation of the camera, while label B handles the image processing. As we'll see later on, some updates will apply to both A and B at the same time, which is the case for the update in this tutorial, while others may do 1 at a time. So it's very important to follow the instructions for your particular camera concerning the sequence, and I'll show you where Nikon places those instructions later in the video. While we're in the setup menus, let's go ahead and format the memory card. I'll hit OK to go back to the grid, then press the down arrow to roll over to the top line for formatting the memory card, and press OK. If you're fine with deleting the data on the card, select Yes, then OK. After the formatting's complete, you can turn off the camera, then remove the card. Next, let's move over to the computer. This is a Windows 10 laptop where I'll launch my browser. Since I'm in the US, I'll enter NikonUSA.com in the address bar, but if you're located elsewhere, you'll want to go to the Nikon site localized to your country. Here, you'll want to hover over Support in the menu, then select Product Support. After scrolling down, I'll hit the Download Manuals and Software button, which takes me to their download center. In the search box, simply type in the name of your camera model. In my case, it's D5100, and it'll auto-return any matching models directly below the text box. After clicking the result, then hitting the search button, you should see a page for the D5100 product, where you can choose the middle button called Firmware. Let me scroll down a little. As you can see, the latest firmware available is 1.02 for label A and 1.01 for label B, released on this date. If you recall, my camera showed 1.01 for both A and B. The instructions for applying the firmware will be shown when you click on the View Download Page link, which states that this software allows for a simultaneous update of both A and B firmware to the latest version. When I apply this update, it'll increment my A to 102 but keep my B at 101. After scrolling down a bit, you can read about the changes that have been made in this update. It looks like they've fixed the reporting of battery life for a very specific battery model. If you're not affected by this fix, let's say you're not using this particular battery, then you may want to skip this update because it won't do anything for you. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Otherwise, let's continue. The next section details how to find your current firmware, which we've done already, and scrolling down even more, you'll see instructions specific to your camera model. In fact, you may want to review the step-by-step instructions for your operating system to confirm the procedure that I take in this video. Returning to the Instructions tab, we can scroll down to the next section, which lists the system requirements for Windows and Mac OS X. Last but not least, once you've reviewed and agreed to the license agreement, go ahead and click the checkbox to accept, then hit the big download button. After the file's been transferred, I'll open its location, which happens to be in my Downloads folder. Double-clicking the file will automatically create a folder called D5100 Update, in which you'll find a file with the extension of bin. This is the firmware update file. What you'll want to do next is take the memory card and insert it into the laptop. This launches another instance of File Explorer. Drag the file over to the root directory of the memory card, as I show here. Afterwards, I can right-click on the card, labeled Nikon D5100, hit Eject, and physically remove the card from the laptop. Let's now insert the card into the camera, then turn it on. After pressing the menu button, I'll roll over to the bottom row of the setup menu by pressing up, then click OK. Since you have the firmware on the memory card, it'll detect that file and give you the option to update. Select it, then press OK. It'll show you the simultaneous updates of the A and B firmwares, though only A will be incremented. If everything looks good, shift over to Yes, then press OK. At this point, according to Nikon, do not remove the memory card, turn the camera off, operate any of the camera controls, attach or remove lenses, unplug or disconnect the AC adapter if you're using one, remove the battery, or subject the camera to powerful electromagnetic noise. Simply wait until it's done. This could take some time, so I'll go make some chicken nuggets in the toaster oven and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. It took a little over 2 minutes to complete the update. It'll now ask you to turn the camera off, and then, to verify that the update actually took, I'll turn it back on again, then return to the menu. Go back to the firmware screen, where you'll see the firmware labeled A has indeed been updated to 1.02, while B remains 1.01. To remove the firmware file from your memory card, you can simply reformat the card again. Going back to my laptop, we won't need the downloaded files anymore, so I'll return to the Downloads folder, where I'll select both the executable file and the extracted folder, right-click, and delete them. With that, you're now all cleaned up and ready to take photos with the latest software available for your camera. You can follow the same procedure to upgrade the firmware for your lens, but if you'd like a walkthrough video guide on that specific subject in the future, please let me know in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.